We have a very special Brandlove in store today. Stick around until the end because you're not going to want to miss this one. With the earliest known imagery originating from around 6 years ago, the WunderTRE brand has seen its fair share of change-ups. Making its way into the scene on April 15, 2016, founder and CEO Riker Taylor had a plan to improve people's lives by creating messaging that small businesses could use to better their products or services. Thus, WunderTRE Digital Marketing was born. Originally specializing in branding, various marketing strategies, and web design, WunderTRE has stuck with its core values since its inception. A few of those core values are to have standards and help everyone get there, make business decisions that help improve people's experience, and make our processes a joy to experience. WunderTRE has had a grand opportunity for outreach over the last 6 years and uses client interaction to help continually build a top quality experience for everybody who gets in touch. Now onto our next segment, the good and the bad. WunderTRE has one thing with its branding that really stands out. The drive for customer experience and the dedication to making processes joyful and not a drag to go through for clients is a stance that only can be summed up in one word, iconic. What better way to embody the phrase with a very strong iconic logo? The WunderTRE icon has made its way into many pieces of the collateral. Bumpers on videos, offset on social media posts, and so much more. The WunderTRE icon has proven time and time again that it's ultra capable of standing on its own. Very strong branding comes from the core, and in my professional opinion, the core of any brand is the logo. WunderTRE's icon finds a way to substantiate that, just like many prominent national brands do. If you've seen any of the previous brand loves, you know that many of the brands that I fall in love with have very strong iconography. Did you really think that this episode was gonna be all good bias? No, no, friends, that's not how we do things around here. Nobody is safe from criticism. Nobody. From dabbling in 8-bit / retro style graphical elements to the wave pattern of new, WunderTRE's brand has been ever changing to say the least. With good intention, this kind of thing isn't necessarily bad. What symbolizes bad in the WunderTRE brand is that the tree logo heavily outweighs the font in terms of iconic branding. These two elements that have stayed the same since the dawn of this brand have always clashed. The stylistic and aesthetic changes are something that should have stayed consistent, but nothing ever seemed to fit with the current logo. I truly think it's because these are two completely different genres of a logo. A strong solo icon battling with a middling solo typeface. Not a great combo. Kind of like ketchup and chocolate chip cookies. Disgusting. Now on to what I'd change. So the funny thing about that is, what I'd change is, well, what we did change. As I said in the good and the bad section, one of the WunderTRE brand's weakest points was the font. After drawing inspiration from modern brands like MailChimp, the team decided to make the font be able to stand out on its own, just like the icon can. Straying from the harder corners and leaning into a softer look brings this brand full circle and matches the most recent aesthetic of this wave pattern. We hope you enjoyed this official reveal of our new rebrand. I speak for the entire WunderTRE team when I say thank you for joining us on this journey. Don't forget to check out our downloadable resources like the blog we just wrote on the rebrand, and also don't forget to check us out on social media. Until next one, au revoir. Oh, local episodes are coming.